Hi, I'm Andy Pease. I'm a principal at Inbalance Green Consulting. I'm really excited to be here today. We're working on videos to show you a passive house, and we're really excited to be working with Mike Horgan of Karen Collaborative. He's a builder, and we get to work with him too, and so we've been blogging about this house during design, and now here we are at the construction site. So we'll bring up Mike and Hannah, and they'll be able to tell you all about the house, and we'll walk through it as construction goes along.
Hi, I'm Mike Horgan. I'm the builder at this house. The company I have is Karen Collaborative. I work with Inbalance Green Consulting and Andy as a construction advisor. It's one of my favorite jobs I've ever had in my life is working in the office with these people. They played a big role in helping this project come together. Though we're physically building it, I think the advice that came from that office has helped push this whole project along. So this house is a 2,900 square foot passive house that will be pursuing certification. It's 2,400 square feet of conditioned floor area. It's following all of the principles of passive house, which is a total of five. It's a wood frame construction with a wood fiber exterior insulation, cellulose-based interior insulation, and passive house airtightness.
Okay, so the five passive house principles are airtight construction. We're gonna make sure that it's continuous everywhere. We have insulation, so superior insulation for the house. Windows, using really good windows that will also help with that airtight barrier. Mechanical ventilation, so because we are making the house so airtight, we still want to make it breathable, comfortable, and healthy. So we're going to use with heat recovery as well with our mechanical ventilation. And the final principle, thermal bridging. So I want to make sure that we do not have thermal bridges, and that's anywhere where energy can go from the inside to the outside of the thermal boundary.
I've been trying to build without gas for a long time and have been successful building without gas in the past. You know, it's not necessary for us to use gas in homes anymore. We really shouldn't be. It was meant to be a transition fuel, and we are now more than capable of transitioning off of that fuel in the homes that we build. So a few things played into that decision here. The homeowners were all for it. They're both environmentalists, though it's not their full-time job. It's a goal to tread lightly on the planet, and they knew that they could do that given the privilege of being able to build a home like this. Another big aspect of it was the cost. So the cost of running gas to this house, even though we have a main right here in front of me on the home side of the sidewalk, and we were gonna run about 90 feet to the side of the garage, the cost came back at $11,000. So we weighed that $11,000 cost against the PV system that we would need for this level passive house, and the PV system's only $9,400. So economically, it made a lot of sense for us to skip the trenching and running of a gas line to the house, and we've put that money towards the PV system and a few other upgrades. You know, that leftover $1,500 gets us a little nicer front door handle. So that played a big factor in moving away from the gas. So.
Great.